Hooking up a synthesizer is super easy, right? Just connect the USB cable and you're done. But what if you want to sync two drum machines in a live setup? No computer. What if you bought an old school keyboard off eBay? No USB. Or what if you want to control one synthesizer from a different synthesizer? You cannot directly connect USB, right? Well, in that case, we're back to the old school 5-pin MIDI connection. And let's make a video for Lloyd Dorsey and talk about some possible setups and some possible traps when we're using the classic MIDI connections. This is the typical MIDI trio. In is the input, and this is where the synthesizer receives data and it will react to this data, for example, playing incoming notes. Then we have the output, and the output will, of course, output MIDI commands, but only MIDI data that you generate on your synthesizer or your keyboard itself. For example, from pressing a note or from moving a slider. MIDI through is also an output, but MIDI through will only output data it receives on the input. And that's the very first trap a lot of people fall into, because out and through are both outputs, but out will only output stuff I generate on the keyboard, and through will only output data that comes into the input. There is no mixing of MIDI data happening. But there are exceptions. There are, for example, MIDI controller keyboards that can merge MIDI data. Or the DeepMind 12 that I'm using here has a function called soft through. And when I'm switching this on, this mixes the MIDI data. But this, and keep this in mind, this is the exception, and this usually has to be activated. If you have an older synth, then there is mostly no mixing of MIDI data happening. The simplest connection is, of course, between two devices, and you always would connect the MIDI output to the MIDI input. And if you have more than two devices, you would do a serial connection. That means going from out to MIDI in, from MIDI through to MIDI in, and from here, from MIDI through to the next input, and so on and so on. This works great, for example, if you're sending a clock, but if you're playing a note, that would mean all synths in a row would play the same note. Before we fix this, let's look at some typical studio setups. Now, if you have one of these USB controllers and you're maybe looking into getting one of the nice Behringer analog synthesizers in the studio, to be honest, let's stick to USB. That keeps it simple. If you bought a synth without USB and you have one of these controllers, then it's easy. Simply use the MIDI output on your USB controller. Because the controller doesn't have built-in sounds, there aren't any problems. Simply choose the controller as MIDI output in your music software. Now, if you're having a synthesizer like the DeepMind 12 here, and you want to use this as a synthesizer, as a master keyboard, but also as a MIDI interface for synths without MIDI, then simply do the serial connection. MIDI out, MIDI in, MIDI through, MIDI in, and so forth. But now we're back to this problem: when I'm playing a note, all synths are playing this note. And this is a super easy fix, because MIDI has actually 16 separate channels. We simply have to assign a separate channel to each device. On some synthesizers, you do it through the menus. On the Model D, for example, or the Neutron, you do it through these little dip switches on the back. And on the DeepMind, you'll find it in the global menu. Now, the DeepMind is pretty sophisticated, so it has different MIDI settings for MIDI over classic MIDI, over USB, and over Wi-Fi. I'm connected through USB here, so I'm selecting USB, and then I'm setting the RX channel to channel 1. Now, the DeepMind receives, that is what RX means, on MIDI channel 1, the Model D receives on MIDI channel 2, and the Neutron receives on MIDI channel 3. And the DeepMind also has to be in local off mode. If you don't know what local off is, check the video in the description. And now I simply can, by selecting the different MIDI channels in my music software, play all the different synths individually over the single MIDI connection. That's great. But what about the clock? Well, the clock is MIDI channel independent, so all synths will still receive the clock and will also react to the clock. Last tip, if you want the perfect setup, you can configure your music software to show the different synths directly. I'm a Pro Tools user on the Mac, so I would use the audio MIDI setup and add all the synths as separate devices with the matching MIDI channel here. And now I can select them in Pro Tools directly and I don't have to think about the MIDI channels again. Now, what are your MIDI setup tricks? Let us know in the comments. If you have any questions, please ask there also. Please like and subscribe. See you soon. Bye bye and arrivederci.